There are actually two types of formulas. The default is what we call a relative formula, but in addition to that, there is a formula reference that we call absolute, which refers to a specific location. I have said earlier that as you're creating formulas, you want to always think about making yourself efficient, and if you set up one formula correctly, you should be able to copy or use autofill to fill that formula into the other cells, and it would work correctly. However, we're going to see now that there's an instance when that wouldn't actually work for you. In this example, you can see it's very simple. We're looking at purchasing boxes of candy bars, and the sales tax is listed. We're going to put this formula in by, as always, clicking where we want our answer to go. And it is just simple multiplication. There isn't anything fancy that we're going to do that, so we're going to type that formula in ourselves. All formulas begin with the equal sign. I am going to use the mouse to help me select the other cells that I want to use. I'm going to take my Snickers bars times the current tax rate that I have listed here. And if I want to use autofill, I might do the check mark to finish this formula, my strategy of where I want and what I want to do next. This is a relative formula because I have not done anything special to it. So I'm actually going to copy that formula down, and when I do, I will see that I get errors in the formula. I like to perhaps look at my first wrong answer and see what went wrong in this formula. I'm going to click in the first one, and it was taking B4 and multiplying that by D1, which is where my sales tax amount is. If I click in the first wrong answer, it took B5. So in other words, we did take, and we were in the Snickers, and we moved down to Milky Way. But notice where it looked for the sales amount. It looked for the sales amount in D2. A relative formula makes the same move as you move down relative to the cell that you've copied it into. For example, we started out in column C where we were looking for our answer, and we referenced B4 and D1. When we copy that formula down into cell C5, the formula that we copied moves down exactly the same amount that we did. And the new formula will reference B5, which we wanted it to do, move down from Snickers to Milky Way price, but it made the same exact move on the tax amount. And notice that when you move down from D1 into cell D2, no longer does that cell contain the correct tax amount. So what we need to do is change this to an absolute reference. So our formula needs to be modified to no longer allow cell D1 to make the same relative move that we made. We need it to absolutely always stay and look for the current tax amount in D1. And that's what we're going to do next by putting in an absolute reference. Correct. We stated that D1 is where we want our absolute reference, and we know why now. So I'm going to edit this formula using the formula bar. I'm simply going to click anywhere near D1. It could be in front of it, beside it, in the middle of it. I just need to activate so that Excel knows the part of the formula I want to be editing and making changes to is D1, not B4. And you know me, I like to do things the easiest way possible, so I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut to insert the absolute reference. You could type it in yourself, but I'm going to do it on the keyboard. By pressing the F4 key, the function key F4, which is located across the top of your keyboard, if I hit F4 instantly, it puts dollar signs in front of the D and in front of the 1. It's actually We'll cycle through all your possible choices. If I hit F4 again, the dollar sign is only on row 1. If I hit F4 again, it's only on column D. And the last time I hit it, it will remove those dollar signs. So you can see that it will cycle around to all the possible choices. In this example, as I fill down, what changes is rows. When I fill down, in this example, I'm going from C4 down to C5, down to C6, down to C7. So what changes is 4, 5, 6, 7. Therefore, I know that my dollar sign or my absolute value must be in front of the row, not the column number. So I'm going to place the dollar sign only in front of the 1 so that it will always stay in row 1 and never move down to row 2, row 3, row 4 when it's looking for that tax amount. Again, I'm going to use a check mark to finish, and I'm going to autofill and copy that formula down. Note that this time the formula does work, and I'm going to click in one of my answers and just verify, looking at the formula bar, that it actually did make the right move. So from now on, when you're doing formulas, let's summarize what you have to keep in mind. First, you're thinking that you're going to set up one cell and be able to use autofill. So I'm always thinking ahead at autofill. I want to be able to copy the contents of this formula into the other cells. And also, I'm looking to see, is there anything that needs to be absolute? Or is there any part of this formula that absolutely does not move down when I copy and move and fill that formula down into other cells?